You mentioned a bunch of innovation that occurred in DeFi and in kind of crypto. And one of those is AMMs, which obviously is a core piece of the infrastructure to make a lot of these decentralized exchanges work. My understanding, and you'll kind of correct me here if I misstate anything, but basically it's taking the idea of the AMM and the liquidity pools and bringing that into kind of a more institutional, regulated, centralized type structure with Bullish. Talk a little bit about that innovation around the liquidity pools and the AMMs, and like why is that so effective and so innovative? And then how you guys are thinking about bringing this to more of a Wall Street type audience?
First of all, typically the exchange with the most liquidity wins, and exchanges tend towards kind of oligopolistic market structures. Not one exchange, maybe more than two, but not necessarily more than 10 or 15. For a particular asset, because people like to have more liquidity concentrated in fewer places. And what liquidity means is, let's say I want to buy Bitcoin or I want to sell Bitcoin, or I want to buy ETH, I want to sell it. I want to know for the amount that I want to buy, how much is it going to cost me? Meaning when I buy it, how much is the overall market going to move against me, such that the mark-to-market value of my asset is going to be less at the conclusion of my trade. And in a perfect world, that movement is zero. But you're never really going to reach that theoretical zero. There's always going to be some cost because you have to pay the people who are providing the liquidity. So exchanges all around the world are in this eternal quest to be able to effectively increase the number of bids and offers that they can get, in particular around the current market price. And whoever does that best wins. And I remember just an anecdote way back, I don't even remember the year, maybe it was 2007 or 8, I launched a new coffee futures contract and I was all excited about it. And I traveled all, I went to all these coffee guys like Nestle, and everybody wanted it. Everybody, it was a Robusta coffee contract. They really needed it to be able to hedge their coffee. And then we launched it and it was just crickets, because the first person who shows up to provide liquidity, they're gonna end up losing a lot of money. And it's difficult to find the market makers who are gonna make markets in coffee. And so I wanted to create our own liquidity as an exchange. I wanted to be able to provide our own bids and offers, but I wasn't clever enough to figure out the model that worked, the model that worked financially, the model that worked with the regulators. And I had the same experience later launching a CDS index product in Europe, so on and so forth. And it wasn't until about a year and a half ago when I started studying these DEXs, and in particular, the DEXs that use the AMMs, mostly powered by something called the Bancor algorithm. And the light bulb went off. I said, aha, this is it. This is like BYOB, like bring your own liquidity as an exchange. I can launch as an exchange and I can use this automated market maker model, which I use the term liquidity pool synonymously. So if I go back and forth, I'm talking about the same thing. And all of a sudden you have a way to populate bids and offers, and you're not beholden to any one market maker. You're not beholden to 10 market makers. You're not beholden to the same crowd of people that are making the same prices on a whole bunch of other exchanges. And just to go back 10 minutes, when our guy Elon puts out a tweet, and they pull back their prices on every single exchange. So if you're just doing that, you're not unique. You're not going to win this, eternal quest I talked about. But if you're using an automated market maker model, all of a sudden you can have a unique and differentiated form of liquidity. And so that's really what got me excited.
Hey, you, did you like this video? Great. We make 5 of them a day and post them here on this channel. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, and see you next time.